today, I want to invite you to join me in my weekly love challenge. I want you to imagine this. You and I, along with people from all over the world, doing exercises every single week to help us learn how to become a more deep and mature lover. I mean, imagine if you're waiting on your person, if you're believing for your match, somewhere doing these same exercises, learning how to become deeper and mature in love, and you're doing the same thing. Whoa, when you and your match get together, that is going to be dynamic for the kingdom of God. And so I want to invite you to join me every single week. I'm going to post here a new exercise and a new challenge. And for the entire week, we're going to practice learning how to love in that way. I'm going to base it off of 1 Corinthians 13, where it talks about how love is patient and love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It's not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. And so I believe that every single thing that you are desiring, every single thing that you are believing for, believing by faith, contending for, that promise, that dream, whatever that is for you, I believe everything that is for you is on the other side of love. I believe there is full access to it as you continue to go deeper and mature in love. And that's what we're going to be doing. We're going to be intentional about love. We're going to practice it every single day, the same exercise. And if you, don't do so well one day, that's the beauty of practice. You got the next day, a whole brand new day to step into this exercise of learning how to become a more mature lover. There was a man, an old prophet by the name of Bob Jones, and he had this experience where he died, and he ended up coming back. But while he was gone, he says how he goes to this place, and there's this person of light there, and there are all these people, and like this long line of people, and everyone that comes up to this one dressed in white, this light, they're asked the same question, and that question is, did you learn how to love? And so he gives an example of this African-American woman who comes up, and she has like all of these angels with her, and she walks up. And the thing about being in the presence of God, because your innermost being is created by God, the scripture says all souls are mine, right? This is what God says. So when you're standing in the presence of God, even if you're having a spiritual experience and you're still here on this side, but you have a vision or a trance or even a dream that appears to be very real, if you're in the presence of God, your innermost being will speak out, and truth has to come out from you. You have no choice but to proclaim the truth when you're in front of your Creator. And so the voice asked her if she learned to love, and she said, yes, I did. And she threw her hands up, and she was kissed by God. It was almost like God's chest opened up and she walked right in. It was like two double doors. And he talks about another woman, an older woman. He says she was about 93 or so, and she had all of these things all over her body because she had experienced a lot of arthritis in her life. And when she got up to the light, she was asked the same question, did you learn how to love? And truthfully, she spoke out. She said, I learned how to love you, Lord. But after my husband died when I was very young, and I became very bitter, and I was always going against the saints, going against people. And he says, okay, well, you did learn to love me, and so you're saved, but you have no works. And he sends her to where she's gonna go. And so I believe that when this is all said and done, that's gonna be the question. Did you learn how to love? And so I want to invite you, join me. We're gonna do this weekly challenge of learning how to become a deeper and more mature lover. It's going to consist of exercises to love God more deeply and more maturely, exercises to love yourself more deeply and maturely, and exercises to love each other more deeply and maturely. And so I am really excited, and I hope you will join me. I'll see you next week.